Hi there, as usually it's me, just a voiceover, and you're watching Review Machines. So glad to see you again, my friends. Today we've got for the review a machine made by legendary USSR factory Dektyarev. They produced various weapons during the Second World War, and now one of their fields is producing various vehicles, including this one. This ATV is called Z-Berkan. Today we will make the thorough test of this machine and look at it in detail. You might have already seen some similar ATVs on our channel, but most of them were hammer-made. This time it's interesting to review such an ATV, but made by a serious factory. And first of all, I would like to say a word about the exterior. Yes, it's rather rough at a first glance, but if you look at it in detail, we can notice that everything is done quite neatly and the whole design is rather effective. But now let's look how it's built. The whole construction is a classic trike. First of all, we notice here huge low-pressure wheels. The diameter of the wheels is 1020 mm and 420 mm width. Look at the wheel discs. They have these sticking out metal parts. Due to them, it's very easy to equip the wheels with chains to provide better traction on off-roading. The front wheel has a suspension system, but there is no any suspension at the rear. The trike is equipped with a motorcycle engine Lifan. It's 200cc 4-stroke water-cooled engine, 12 HP. It works with a mechanical gearbox with 5 ranges. Besides, there is a reducer that provides low and rear range. And finally, we have here a parking brake. The rear axle is driven by a double-strengthened chain. There is no differential at the rear axle, but one of the wheels can be switched off by this gear. In this way, it's easier to steer on a good road and asphalt. The radiator is mounted at the rear. There are two durable trunks that can sustain quite weighty loads. There are some old-school lights and the same handlebar, and probably the most minimal dashboard I've ever seen. And finally, the engine can be started both by electric starter and by a kick starter. Well, let's try to ride it! First of all, you should know that the steering is the same like on old school motorcycle with the manual gearbox. So if you have never ridden such bikes, be prepared to spend some time to get the hang of the steering with the mechanical gearbox. Actually, the CVT transmission would be easier for handling, but as we know, any CVT is not good for real off-roading. As to the comfort when riding, well, front suspension definitely works, but there is no any suspension at the rear, so sometimes it feels quite tough for riding, thanks to the huge low-pressure wheels that somehow soften the roughnesses. The engine in general is powerful enough, cause there is a reducer that provides good torque, and if we switch to the low gear, there is enough torque to move even without pushing throttle at all. Well, that were my very first impressions of the machine. Now we'll let more skilled rider to show us everything this ATV can do. One of the main advantages of this trike is low pressure on the ground. It's even possible to ride over a man lying on the ground. But actually, we didn't manage to find any volunteers to test it. The whole weight of the machine is 330 kilos, but due to the huge low-pressure wheels, the ATV doesn't damage the ground at all. It's both good for off-roading capabilities and for environment. The ground clearance is 340 mm. That allows to overcome quite a rough surface of the ground, but you should remember that all the trikes don't like side rolls, so be careful when riding along the slopes. Then I should mention that Berkan is definitely not very fast. According to the official specs, the maximum speed is 40 km per hour, but in fact the maximum comfortable speed is about 30. On the other hand, the trike has a good torque for moving on loose grounds like sand, swamp and snow. Well, let's test these abilities of the ATV. We found the decent swamp. And first of all, let's try to ride across the swampy carpet. As we can see, it's a snap for the backend to move here. Big heavy off-roaders most probably would get stuck here, but we are able to get over the swamp without any difficulties. Well, let's try to cross the deep swampy lake. Actually, we are sure that the ATV can float on water due to the big wheels, with the load up to 150 kilos on board the machine. But the question is, if it is able to move here? Frankly speaking, we had some doubts about it, cause in fact it's a rear-wheel drive machine. But to my surprise, backend moves here. Yes, it moves quite slow, but it moves. But definitely it's a matter of practice. Only experienced rider can get over such obstacle. The point is that you need to choose a proper speed of rotation of the wheels to provide the maximum traction in these conditions. After all, we managed to cross this lake, but the problem is to get out from water to the ground. The only way to do that is to move backwards. In this way, it's much easier for the ATV to solve this task. Well, we tested the ATV on swamp, but what about the clean open water? Let's try to test this machine in the lake. And again, to my surprise, the ATV managed to show us quite a decent speed moving on water. We tested numerous amphibious ATVs, and I should say, we see here a really good result, especially taking into account that the backer is a rear-wheel drive machine. Moreover, it's also have quite efficient ability to maneuver on water. Actually, it's a rare feature for the amphibious ATVs. But now let's get back to the ground. And now our traditional topic – the prices. And there are two variants. If you don't need to register this machine, its price is $2,500 without documents. But if you need to register it, the price will be $3,000 with all the necessary documents. Well, let's call it a day now. Please post your comments with your opinions about this ATV. Thanks for watching, my friends. Consider subscribing the channel if you like this video. Stay with us, there will be many more interesting materials here. Goodbye.